జాతీయ హెల్త్ సెక్రటరీ లవ్ అగర్వాల్ మాట్లాడుతున్నారు లైవ్ చూద్దాం
హై లెవెల్ ఇంక్రీస్డ్ దేర్ వాస్ లెస్ ఆపర్చునిటీ ఫర్ ఇన్ఫెక్షన్స్ టు స్ప్రెడ్ అ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ అ స్టాండింగ్ లెవెల్ ఆఫ్ ఇమ్యూనిటీ ఇన్ ద పాపులేషన్ అండ్ కాషనరీ స్టెప్స్ హాల్టెడ్ దిస్ స్ప్రెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద ఫస్ట్ వేవ్ అండ్ కాస్ట్ డిక్లైన్ Unless new opportunities arise, this would have been the situation. New opportunities came about all over the world and in India too. If cautionary steps decline, new opportunities for spread arise. What happens if we drop our guard? The level of caution drops, but also so does the standing level of immunity is often not enough to stop infection spreading. Many people get infected until we reach a new immunity threshold. Such a second wave is typically smaller than the first. Such a second wave was expected. However, multiple parameters can change in small amounts and add up to a second wave much larger than the first. Each parameter may seem a small change, but together, because the rise is exponential, this adds up enormously. Such a much larger second wave with the ferocity we are seeing was not predicted. Now, what contributes to a large second wave? What were the opportunities open to the virus? After a first wave, immunity can keep new infections low. However, immunity may not have been widespread, and the fraction uninfected due to cautionary steps they have taken in the first wave may have been large. Immunity can also fade. Someone who has recovered could be reinfected, but we know that after 8 months of being infected, protection is still very high. It's about 80%. But could that 20% be sufficient to cause immune evasion of significance? So the combination of less caution, less immunity in a population from the first wave, and the consequent opening up of access to the virus drives a large second wave. In other words, as long as variants are not immune evasive substantially, their being more transmissible is important, but that alone will not cause a big surge unless cautionary steps decline and a large population is available for infection. What role do the variants play in the size of the second wave? Let us look at that. And to do that, we have to see how SARS coronavirus 2 was successful so quickly. This virus emerged in late 2019 in Wuhan. And at that time, it was a virus which we could call a generalist. It could infect many mammal species, minks, cats, dogs, etc. And it indicates that it's not specifically a tightly human-adapted virus. Now, this didn't change much in all of 2020, and all the evolutionary signals show evidence for this lineage to continue in the same way. The first 11 months of the SARS coronavirus 2 evolution had a relatively low accumulation, slow accumulation of mutations, about 2 mutations per month in global lineages. Generally, not much of what is called adaptive evolution was detected, with one exception, which we can go through later if needed. Now, the second phase started sometime in October 2020 and has gone on now in April, May 2021. Now, one example of that dramatic change in that period was the B.1.1.7. While people had already studied how changes in the spike protein, which is a key aspect of the virus for it to infect us, could change the antibody sensitivity, people did not predict this kind of accumulation of mutations to give rise to a lineage like B.1.1.7. So that was indeed somewhat of a surprise. And this mutation, this set of mutations, could have arisen in an immune-compromised individual where lots of opportunities for change can take place. Now, there are two points about the virus. As I said, it started off as a generalist, a rough, crude key which can fit into many locks. Now, as transmission increases and mutations which increase transmission take place, the key becomes more and more refined and more specific. But there's only so much that transmission can be perfected. You cannot go beyond a certain level. But the very same region of the spike protein, which is involved in increasing transmission, is also involved in other activities of the virus, such as how the host system responds with antibodies towards it. So viruses which are better and better at transmission can also accumulate changes which allow for antibody evasion, immune evasion, or vaccine evasion. That has not happened substantially yet with these variants, but that's something, as I said, could be important. So most antibodies target the spike protein in an area which is called the receptor binding motif. And this kind of variation has been well studied by scientists all over the world. Now in early 2021, something changed rather importantly. A very large number of people all over the world had been infected. Now, as I said, as immunity increases,